Hi everybody, welcome back to another video from Wesno's Tech News and Reviews. Today, we're going to be doing an accuracy test, a heart rate accuracy test of the all-new Fitbit Lux versus the Huawei Band 6, the all-new fitness tracker from Huawei. So basically, we got results that were slightly unexpected. Anyways, let's get into it. All right, so just yesterday, I've actually done an initial impressions review of the Fitbit Lux. So the tracker right here on my left wrist. Now, it's being advertised as a tracker with color. Well, yeah, but it's like having wheels on cars, right? Every other car has wheels. Well, the Fitbit Inspire and the Inspire 2 did not have wheels. It was black and white. Now it's saying it's in color. Well, it's a car that has wheels. Well, duh, okay, everybody else does. But anyway, for £130 or $130, I was expecting for this fitness tracker to be a bit more special. Also, I managed to drop it yesterday from just 1.5 feet, and I've already managed to dent the case, which is plastic. For that price, I don't know. Also, in regards to features and functions, I did not find it was, well, it didn't have that many special features to it. It's just all standard. If we talk about sport modes, so yep, there are 20 sport modes that you can have on it, and you can set them up from your app. On the actual tracker, you can get just 6 slots at any time. Also, you get auto track, which does auto detect up to 6 activities, which is great. Now, small, tiny 1.1-inch AMOLED display. Now, with the Huawei Band 6, something much bigger, better. You get a 1.47-inch AMOLED display, edge to edge, and it really does look like a smartwatch. You get 90 sport modes. That's way more than 20, obviously. 4.5 times more than that. Also, with the Fitbit Lux, so they're saying SpO2 on demand is coming sometime later in the future, God knows when, via an OTA update, so over the air. Now, with the Huawei Band 6, you don't have to wait. You get it, and you get continuous SpO2 monitoring. Lovely. Connected GPS on both. Both are waterproof. Both do continuous heart rate tracking. Both do your stress management. Both give you 3 sleep stages and a sleep score, as well as guidance on how to improve your sleep. There are breathing exercises, your timer, your stopwatch, weather widgets, all the basic stuff. It's got all that. So basically, the Fitbit Lux does a lot of the things that a budget fitness tracker does, but it costs way more and has a smaller screen, like way smaller. Now let's talk about the actual test. So what I actually did, I went to the gym. I was doing exercise for just under 25 minutes. So first I was on the treadmill, so I ran for about 1 mile, and then I got off the treadmill and I started doing exercise for the core, a bit of exercise with some weights, so some lunges, some squats, did a couple of bench presses and did some abs. So all up 25 minutes just to keep the heart rate pumping, just to get the intensity up there and to do a full check of the heart rate plots between the two trackers. So the Fitbit Lux on one side and the Huawei Band 6 on the others. Now the benchmark for the heart rate was the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. So this is a chest strap that goes over my chest and is on me while I'm doing the exercise. Now the ECG chest strap is supposed to be the most accurate in terms of heart rates, simply because it does sit on top of your chest and right next to your heart. Now these optical heart rate sensors on the back of the fitness tracks or smartwatches actually emit green LED light onto your skin, and they track the reflection coming back up. From that reflection, they actually measure and track your heart rate. So we do expect that the optical heart rate sensors are not as accurate as the ECG chest straps, but with the Huawei Band 6 from the previous test, we got some excellent results. Like, the results were just astounding. So let's see what the Fitbit Lux has actually come up with. Let's do it. So first of all, let's take a look at the numbers that are shown to us by the Polar ECG chest strap, the H10 ECG chest strap. And we can see that we've got an average heart rate of 134 beats per minute, while the max was peaked at 167 beats per minute, and that happened on the run. So while I was sprinting at the last part of the treadmill run. Now let's take a look at what the Huawei Band 6 came up with. The Huawei Band 6 actually shows us 133 beats per minute for the average, so a 1 beat per minute understatement of the average, and a max, or the peak, was basically registered at 160 beats per minute. That is an understatement of 7 beats per minute, or 4.2%. Okay, so we can see that the peak was slightly off, but the average is still very sharp. Right, so let's see what the Fitbit Lux has actually come up with. And I'll tell you what, unexpected. Because with the Fitbit Lux, I got the impression that it's just a high-priced item. But it looks like the optical heart rate sensor on the back of this thing is very accurate indeed. Take a look at the numbers. So 134 beats per minute registered for the average. So that's spot on with the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. Amazing. Same, no difference, no variance. Now the max was 164 beats per minute. Wow. So that's only 3 beats per minute off from the max. And that's an understatement of just under 2%. These results are quite good. So I think we'll actually have to compare this smartwatch, the Fitbit Lux, versus the GTS 2 Mini, because the GTS 2 Mini is just so accurate. Anyway, let's sum up the results. So we've got the Fitbit Lux, which is, in my view, an overpriced tracker, but it does have a very accurate optical heart rate sensor on the back of this thing. Now, on the other hand, we've got the Huawei Band 6, which costs, well, 3 times less. So 30% of the price of the Fitbit Lux. It's got a much better screen, much bigger screen. It's got more sport modes. It's got more functionality because it's got continuous SpO2. And it's also highly accurate. But the Fitbit Lux is just a little bit more accurate. But again, this was just the first round of tests. This is the second day that I've got the Fitbit Lux with me. So I will be making further tests of it. I will be checking its auto track functionality, see if it can actually detect sports like it says it does. And of course, we'll be waiting for the SpO2 update. Anyways, thank you for watching the Wesnos Tech News and Reviews channel. If you did enjoy this video, if you do like our content, please drop us a like. And if you want to see more of the same, just hit the red subscribe button below the video. I will see you in the next one.